Hello. Today we are in Proverbs chapter 13, verse 12. Hope deferred makes the heart sick, but when the desire comes, it is a tree of life. Hope deferred. We want to be able to see things happen. Now we want to see things. Don't hope for it to be happened. If you don't defer your hope, enjoy, live in hope now. Why? Well, I'm going to wait to the future to be happy. Live your life now and say, you know what? I'm with Jesus. I have victory. And if you're not with Jesus, you can be with Jesus right now. Hey, why not? I haven't done this yet in this series. Hey, Romans 10:9, I know it's not a proverb, says that if you confess your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. So if you don't know Jesus right now, you don't have to wait. And if you're a Christian, a lot of Christians live in a miserable life too because they defer their hope. Realize you can live in the victory now. Yeah, it looks like things around us don't seem to be going our way. But here's the thing: God is using everything to bring as many people to Him as possible, and you're part of that plan, and you're safe in His hands. All you gotta do is put yourself in a relationship with Him, and trust me, He protects those who are in a relationship with Him. So how do you become one? Well, we just say this prayer with me: Dear Jesus, I thank you that you came to earth, you died for me, even when I didn't deserve it. And then you came back to life, not to get even with me, but to say that you love me and you want to spend all of eternity with me and have a relationship with me starting right now. And Jesus, I want to have an amazing relationship with you starting right now. Amen. And if you have that, you don't have to defer your hope anymore. Your hope is there because you're going to be in heaven one day. Life is really short, forever, really, really long. And when you get to heaven, you're going to realize, oh, wow, there wasn't much to this life. All those things I thought were horrible were nothing. Because, boy, great is my reward. And we do not have to do that. Verse 13 of chapter 13. He who despises the word will be destroyed, but he who fears the commandment will be rewarded. And what's God saying here? If you despise what God has to say, well, you kind of get what you deserve. Now, fear. Now, are we supposed to be afraid of what God says? No. Fear really means the word awe. Do we take it and say, you know what? If I do this, I fear because now I'm against God. Do you want to be against God? No, you don't want to be fighting against God. A lot of people, that's what's wrong with them. They're actually fighting with God. There's no need to fight with God. God doesn't want to fight with you anyways. Okay. But we tend to do that because, okay, I'm going to do it my way. But God says, I can't be with you there. And you're like, well, God's fighting against me. He's not really fighting against you. He just can't bless when you choose wrongly. And he gave us his word. Now, here's the thing. In the Bible, God says, do you have to know everything memorized? No, not a bad idea. But you know what? As you learn more about God's word and you put it in your heart, the more you'll be able to follow him, the more he'll be with you. Now, when you don't know what it is, God doesn't hold that accountable to you. He has the sins of ignorance and the sins of transgression. Transgression is on purpose. Ignorance, oh, I didn't know. But once you know, then James 4:17 comes to play. When you know to do good and you don't do it, then it's sin. And God can't be where sin is. God can't. And he's saying, live your life for me the way I want you to live it for me, and I'll be with you. And you won't find yourself fighting against God. You'll find God fighting for you. Isn't that a better place to be where God fights for you? Wouldn't that be absolutely awesome? I tell you, it is absolutely awesome, especially in relationship with him. And because he says, not only will you following his command, he says, you will be what? Rewarded. Oh, what a great thing that is. The law of the wise is a fountain of life to turn one away from the snares of death. Oh, the law of the wise. Here's the thing. God's law, he has, what gives wisdom? Book learning is great, but then you got to apply. What creates wisdom? You know what creates wisdom? Experience. Actually putting things to the test. Doing things over time. Jesus is called the Ancient of Days. And what that really means is he has no beginning, no end. He's just always been. He's always existed. Which means he has way more experience than any of us. No one has the experience that God has. And you got to also think, God has an experience with us. Why does he want to have an experience of us? I mean, it blows your mind how much he really loves us. But that's, and he says, look to me. Look to the law of the wise. The Bible has every situation imaginable in it. You just got to find it. Another great thing is God's given people to help you find different things. Hey, go ask Google. Hey, what Bible verse deals with this? A whole bunch will come up. And then that's why you gave pastors and teachers and evangelists and prophets and apostles to help us with these things, to help us to say, well, maybe that verse does that. What verse really applies to my situation? Because God, he'll get right down to what you exactly need every single time when you let him do that. Well, I hope you have a great day. And remember, Jesus loves you. I love you, and you're absolutely awesome.